Make no noise.
Mind your weapons. The guard may hear it.
Hey you! Don't dare to touch the deities!
Jai Srila Prabhupada!
Sarkar! Throw the bomb! Throw the bomb, Sarkar!
Bhakti Raghav Swami! Ekadashi Prabhu! Someone please call the ambulance!
March 1984 has formed a deep wound on the body of ISKCON. Their headquarters at Mayapur was attacked. This attack left the devotees injured both physically and emotionally. They barely managed to secure the deity of Srila Prabhupada, but they lost the deity of Srimati Radharani. There was an undercurrent of insecurity in the community. This time, the leaders had to take a serious stand.
Bhavananda Prabhu, we have had enough. This time, these rogues have crossed all limit. They dare to steal Srimati Radharani and Srila Prabhupada.
Not only that, because of those rascals, Bhakti Raghav Swami Maharaj has lost his leg and Ekadashi Prabhu has suffered severe injuries.
And so many devotees have also suffered. This incident has terrorized our entire community.
We need to take some strict action. Why not complain to the police?
Police? What will they do? We have had so many incidents in the past and we have filed so many complaints. But what happened? No action was taken. What do you feel, Bhavanand Prabhu?
Mahajano yena gata sapanta. Let us follow in the footsteps of Acharyas.
In the footsteps of Acharyas?
Yes. In the past, when similar attacks had tried to threaten the devotees at Yogapit, Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur, along with his son, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, had promptly installed in the Yogapit temple the deities of Sri Sri Lakshmi Narasingha Dev. And do you know what? After this, there were no further disturbances.
But Bhavananda Prabhu, this is easier said than done. The pujari must be Naistiki Brahmachari and the worship of Sri Sri Lakshmi Narasimha Dev must be very strict and regulated. Who would worship him?
If we have strong desire, the Lord will certainly help us. Bhakti Siddhanta Prabhu and Atma Tattva Prabhu, why don't you prepare some sketches? I have a form in my mind. The deity's leg should be bent, ready to jump. He should be looking around ferociously. His fingers should be curled and flame should be coming out from his head.
All right, Prabhu. We will make the sketch accordingly.
But question remains the same. Who will be ready to worship Lord Narasingha Dev?
I, Pankaj Angridas, shall worship Lord Narasimha Deva. The devotees of Lord do not depend on any weapon or strength to protect themselves, but they take the complete shelter in the Lord, who incarnates in various forms. Therefore, we shall seek shelter at the lotus feet of Lord Narasimha Deva.
Jai! Jai! Jai!
Dear Atma Tattva Prabhu, please take the charge to bring this ferocious form of Lord Narasimha Dev to Mayapur.
Yes, Prabhu. I will immediately leave for South India. It is a land of rich devotional culture and celestial architecture. We shall definitely find the deities there. Hare Krishna! Hare Krishna!
After long and tiresome journey, by Krishna's grace, Atma Tattva Prabhu soon finds renowned Sthapati. A Sthapati not only sculpts the deities, but is also expert in temple architecture and engineering.
Hare Krishna, my name is Atma Tattva Das. I am from ISKCON and I have come from Navadweep. I have heard you are one of the most famous Sthapatis of South India.
No. That is all Lord Ranganath's mercy. Come, please come and have a seat. Bring some coconut water for him. Yes, tell me, what can I do for you?
Sthapati ji, we wanted you to carve a deity for us.
Is it? What deity?
Well, the deity of Ugra Narasimha Dev.
Ugra Narasimha? Are you sane? Did you say Ugra Narasimha? No. That is not possible.
But why?
No. Once I say it's not possible, means it is not possible. I will not carve this deity.
Sthapati ji, please.
No. I am sorry. You can find someone else.
I have approached so many deity sculptors, but the answer was always the same. No. I have made a number of trips between Mayapur and South India, and 6 months have passed, but there has been no fruitful result. But I am determined to bring Lord Narasimha Dev to Mayapur. Let me try once again to visit the original Sthapati ji. Sthapati ji, I request you again. Please consider our case.
All right, Atma Tattva Prabhu. Let me read to you a chapter from this book of Shilpa Shastra, a scripture that deals with different forms of deities. Please come, sit. Here is the description of Lord Narasimha Deva. He has flame-like mane, a searching glance, and his knees are bent with 1 foot forward, ready to jump from the pillar.
I'm amazed. This is exactly what we wanted. Sthapati ji, please look at the sketch.
I'm impressed. I shall make an outline based on the scriptural description, which can be used as a guide for sculpting a deity. But let me remind you, I shall not carve the deity.
It took Sthapati a week to complete the sketch. Atma Tattva Prabhu returned to Mayapur and showed the sketch to temple authorities. Meanwhile, the Sthapati approached his guru, the Shankaracharya of Kanchipuram.
Pranam, Gurudeva.
Come, my dear son. Tell me, how did you remember me?
Gurudeva, I am in a big dilemma.
And what is that?
Gurudeva, a person approached me, wanting me to carve a special deity.
Which is that deity which has put a Sthapati like you in dilemma, my son?
Gurudeva, the deity of Ugra Narasimha.
What? Ugra Narasimha? Don't do it. Your entire family will be destroyed. By the way, who has asked you to carve this deity?
The Hare Krishna devotees from Navadvip.
I see. They want Ugra Narasimha. Are they aware of the implication of carving and installing the deity of Ugra Narasimha? Such deities were carved over 3000 years ago by very elevated sthapatis. There is a place on the way to Mysore where a very ferocious Ugra Narasimha was installed. The demon Hiranyakashipu is torn open on his lap and his intestines are spilling out all over the altar. Once, the standard of worship used to be very, very high. There was an elephant procession and a festival every day. But gradually, the worship standards declined. And today, that place is like a ghost town. The whole village is deserted. No one can live there peacefully. Is this what they want for their community?
They are insistent. They are constantly coming to me to talk to me about the deity. Apparently, they have some problem with the dacoits. Gurudeva, this is the deity that they want.
This is an Ugra category. But the deity in this mood is called Sthanu Narasimha. He doesn't exist on this planet. Even the demigods in the heavenly planets don't worship a form like this. Yes, this deity belongs to an Ugra category. Ugra means ferocious, very angry. And there are 9 forms within this category. And they are all very fierce. The one they want is Sthanu Narasimha, stepping out of the pillar. Don't carve this deity, my son. It will not be auspicious for you. And I will talk about this to you later. My dear son, please listen to me very carefully. Every holy place has a predominating deity whose mood is accepted by all the other deities installed in that dham. The predominating deity of Navadvip is Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is the most merciful of all incarnations. And therefore, each deity in Mayapur will adopt the same merciful mood. Hence, for them, you can carve Sthanu Narasimha. My dear son, please go ahead and carve the deity of Sthanu Narasimha.
Oh, was that a dream? Or was that the instruction from my Gurudeva?
Dear sir, I have a telegram for you.
Oh, I am amazed to see this letter from my Gurudev. This letter confirms my dream. My Gurudev has given me the instruction to carve Sthanu Narasimha Dev for ISKCON Mayapur.
Unaware of what has transpired between Sthapati and his Guru, the devotees in Mayapur wanted the same Sthapati to carve the deities. For third time, Atma Tattva Prabhu was sent back to try and convince Sthapati to carve the deities.
Hare Krishna Sthapati ji.
Oh, Atma Tattva Prabhu. So, you are back.
Yes, Prabhu. I am back. And I am back with the same request to carve Ugra Narasimha Dev for us.
Of course, I will carve.
Oh, really? Really, you will carve? I am so happy that you have agreed to carve the deity of Lord Narasimha. May I ask you the reason for this sudden change in your decision?
Reason? See, look at this letter from my Gurudev. Initially, my Gurudev asked me to refrain from carving the deity. But later, by his divine mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he has instructed me to carve the deity of Ugra Narasimha, also called as Sthanu Narasimha. By his blessings, I will carve the deity for you.
Haribol! That's wonderful! We are very much grateful to you, Sthapati ji. Please take this advance payment and let me know how much time it will take you to carve the deity.
Oh, to carve the deity? It will take 6 months.
6 months?
Don't worry, the work will be done.
Okay, Sthapati ji, I will meet you then in 6 months.
Now, I have stayed in Holidham of Mayapur for 6 months. Let me return back to South India to collect the deity. Also, I will purchase the paraphernalia to worship Lord Narasimha Dev. Hare Krishna, Sthapati ji.
Oh, Atma Tattva ji. Hare Krishna. What brings you here?
I have now purchased the paraphernalia for the worship of Sri Sri Ugra Narasimha. I am here now to collect the deity.
Deity? What deity?
Deity of Ugra Narasimha.
Have you lost your senses? You have come here to collect the deity of Ugra Narasimha? I have not even got the structural stone for it.
But you had promised me that you will finish the carving within 6 months, Sthapati ji.
Yes, definitely. I will keep my promise. 6 months after getting suitable stone.
What? There are so many stones lying around in the hills of South India. So what's the problem? Besides that, what will I tell to devotees in Mayapur? They are eagerly waiting.
Atma Tattva Prabhu, see, I am not making a grinding mortar. I am making a deity. The scriptures tell us that only a stone that has life can be used to make a Vishnu deity. When you hit 7 points of the stone slab and when they make the sound mentioned in the scriptures, then that stone may be suitable. But there is a second test to indicate whether the stone is a living stone. There is a bug that eats granite, and when it eats from one side of the stone to the other and leaves a complete visible trail behind it, then that second test has passed. That stone is a living stone and expressions can manifest from it. Only from such a slab can I carve your Narasimha Dev. Such stone speaks poetry. All features of deity sculpted from such stone will be fully expressive and beautiful. Please be patient. I have been searching sincerely for your 6-foot slab.
I am amazed, but also very anxious. The devotees in Mayapur are expecting the arrival of deity soon. How am I going to explain this living stone search to them?
Maybe they should decide to make Narasimha Dev from a marble.
Oh, no, no. Please forgive me, Sthapatiji. But I forgot to tell you last time I came that we want a Prahlad Murti as well. We want to worship Prahlad Narasimha Dev. What do you think?
I don't think that will be possible. You want everything done exactly according to the scriptures. Your Narasimha Dev will be 4 feet high. Comparatively speaking, then that will make Prahlad Maharaj to be the size of an amoeba.
But we want Prahlad Maharaj 1 foot high.
Fine, but that means your Narasimha Dev will have to be about 120 feet high.
120 feet? No, no, that is not possible. We want Narasimha Dev 4 feet and Prahlad Maharaj as 1 feet. Please consider our request, Thapati ji.
Okay, okay. I will do as you say.
After 2 months, I have returned to South India. There had been no developments. I shuttled back and forth from Mayapur to South India every 30-40 days. Finally, our stone was found and the Sthapati became a transformed man. For over a week, he hardly spent any time at home. Hour after hour, day after day, he just sat staring at the slab. He had a chalk in hand but didn't draw anything. He refused to allow his laborers to do anything except remove the excess stone to make the slab rectangular. Hare Krishna, Sthapati ji. May I check what is the latest development?
Well, I have made the sketch on the stone.
Oh, is that all? During all these months, we have reached only this far? What will I report in Mayapur? The managers in Mayapur are becoming very impatient. You told me the work will be completed in 6 months, Sthapati ji.
Don't worry. The work will be done. It will be done for sure. Don't worry at all.
Sthapati started carving the deity form with intense care and dedication. After some time, the stone had gone and the shape was visible. It took Sthapati a little over 12 months to finish the deity.
Finally, I have carved the deity of Ugra Narasimha. It was very hard work for me. Now, let me take some rest and visit my family in the village. I will inform Atmatattva Prabhuji about my work after a week. Anyway, it is monsoon season, so I will safely keep the deity in my grass hut. Hey, Subramanian ji, what happened?
Your grass hut?
Yes, yes. What happened to my grass hut?
Your grass hut is on fire.
Oh, Narayana, how is it possible? How is it possible? It's raining so heavily and everything is so damp. How is this possible?
Please hurry up. Your place is on fire.
Wait. I understand why this has happened. Let me call Atmatattva ji first. Atmatattva Prabhu.
Hare Krishna.
Please come urgently here and take your deity of Narasimha Dev.
Sure, Prabhu.
What place is this, Thapatiji? Why have you brought me here?
This is my grass hut. I have safely kept the deity of Narasimhadev here. Let me open the door for you.
Haribol! This form is amazing! Wonderful carving! But what happened to your shade?
This whole shade got burned. Lord Narasimhadev is giving an indication that he wants to go now.
Finally, by his own will, the Lord was taken to Mayapur. An installation of Lord Narasimhadev lasted over 3 days, from 27 July to 30th of July 1986. After this, there were no disturbances, no attacks, no robbery, no dacoits, and no injuries too. With the appearance of Lord Narasimhadev began the era of protection of devotees, both physically and spiritually. He is the one from whom even the fear personified fears, and he is the one who provides fearlessness to his devotees from any situation or calamity, just like he did for Prahlad Maharaj.
Shri Narasimha, Jai Narasimha, Jai Jai Narasimha, Praladesha, Jaya Padma, Mukha Padma Bringa.
Jai Sri Narasimhadev Bhagavan Ki! Can we once again have 3 loud Haribols for this wonderful set of devotees?